Aw, yeah, this is Evil Knievel Pete, along with JW, Big Hoppus, and Eegzoo! We represent 7th period APUS. Yo, shout out to my man, Mr. Cruz. This one's for you. Ayo! So there once was a general named Robert E. Lee who could take down a man faster than a Marine. He had the mind of an Einstein. He definitely was no Julian Weinstein. Born and raised in his home in VA, where his heart lay and wanted to stay.
Following in the footsteps of Light Horse Lee was as bright as anyone could see. He gained his knowledge at West Point College. Gained experience that the Mexican War won it and went on to fight some more, turning to the Civil War.
He was Lincoln's first choice, but he didn't rejoice. When Virginia seceded, Robert E. Lee took a vow and joined the Confederacy. He wanted to fight like a warrior in the South and fight for what he felt was right. Fighter of a puzzle, magician of tactics, legendary greatness, daredevil, careful, favorable, savable, disdainful is what comes to mind when I think of Robert E. Lee.
It's a shame that G. Lee, like any great story, had to come to an end. Grant was just too great for his Confederate mate.
Grant and Lee going toe-to-toe in Richmond, who would be done? In a gamble that was bigger than a camel, Grant attacked Cold Harbor. Time for the great Lee to wake up. Nope, it's too late. Time's up. Over. Negotiation comes and goes faster than the speed of light. Lee was now trapped in a maze. Nothing to do but to accept defeat in the haze. Lee would never forget April 9th, 1865, for that was the day he surrendered at the courthouse. No worries. Lee will be back when the U.S. finally reunites. Nothing surprising about this. The North and South are like Siamese twins, just like General Lee and infinite greatness are. He would go on to lead at Washington College until the time in which he died. Grant and Lee going toe-to-toe in Richmond, who would be done? In a gamble that was bigger than a camel. Grant attacked Cold Harbor. Time for the great Lee to wake up. Nope, it's too late. Time's up. Over. Negotiation comes and goes faster than the speed of light. Lee was now trapped in a maze. Nothing to do but to accept defeat in the haze. Lee would never forget April 9th, 1865, for that was the day he surrendered at the courthouse. No worries. Lee will be back when the U.S. finally reunites. Nothing surprising about this. The North and South are like Siamese twins, just like General Lee and infinite greatness are. He would go on to lead at Washington College until the time in which he died.